mum's actions sort of thing. You want to come up now? Yeah, do you want to up and help me? Sing. So I'm not very tuneful, Isaac. Maybe they'll be able to, boys and girls will be able to hear you singing rather than me. We are going to start, are you on the wave? Hello everybody at school. Hello. Okay, so we're going to start off with Somewhere in Outer Space, God Has Prepared a Place. So everybody knows this one. You can all can stand up in your living room or wherever you are. You can do this one. Alright.
Under take a rest. I am going to read out some shout outs of who's watching. We have got, oh, they're in first tonight, Nanny P and Granda B. And we've got Lily and Bethany and Anne and Raymond. Do you know who that is? Nanny and Granda? We've got Mark Scott and we've got Eliana Levi. Hello, have you got your jammies on yet? And we've got Ruby and we've got Faith and Noah and David Henderson. And we've got Anne and Ronnie and we've got Grace and Hannah. And we've got Reverend Crane. Oh, Isaac is looking very smart. Ooh. Okay, so don't forget to try and get your names in the comment section below, and there's also a little share button as well. You can share with other people to watch too. And we are going to do deep and wide now. You ready? More actions? All right. Okay. Father, we thank you that we can all come together tonight, whether it be around screens or those who are in the church tonight, Lord, to come and praise you through singing and to worship you, Lord. And we thank you for every boy and girl across the country that is watching in tonight, Lord, that they could learn something more about you. Lord, we thank you that the Lord Jesus died on the cross for each and every one of us, Lord. We thank you for boys and girls who have professed your faith and tell others about you, Lord. And we ask that maybe you speak to a heart tonight, Lord, that they would come to know you as their own and personal Saviour, Lord. Grow the children that are that will be saved, Lord. And just be with us tonight as we worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. We have got another action one. I like lots of action choruses. So this will either work really well and get you all your energy used up, or you'll be all riled up and not want to sleep later. So we'll see how it goes. I may never march in the infantry.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery.
Is you, and you might not be a little one tonight, maybe you're one of the big ones. That's talking about everybody, is talking about little ones as in the children of God. Okay, so we're gonna do this one.
Little ones like me. loves the little ones like you, you, you. Jesus loves the little ones like you, you, you. Little ones like you, says a thing I do. Jesus loves the little ones like you.
Good, thank you for your help, Isaac. We are going to have our memory verse for tonight. Okay, so boys and girls, listen up. Okay.
Thank you, Auntie Rachel, and it's good to see you all in tonight. Don't forget, keep your comments all coming. Let us know who's watching and where you're watching from. So, memory verse tonight is from the Old Testament, and it's one of the most popular favourite verses of the Old Testament for, I know, a lot of young people and also a lot of older people as well. It's found in the book of Proverbs, Proverbs chapter 3 and the verse 5. And this week we're going to learn verse number 5, and then, God willing, next week we will learn number 6. But verse 5, we'll say it through together for a few times, and then we'll split it up a wee bit and see how we get on. Okay, so after 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. Now that was good, but let's do it about 100 times better and 100 times louder this time, alright? So, if your mummy and daddy weren't saying it, you give them a wee nudge and tell them they have to say it louder this time, okay? After 2, 1, 2. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. Okay, very good, but I think we'll do better in a wee moment's time. So what is this verse telling us? Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. I wonder sometimes we can all be like this, that we all think that we know better than somebody else, and when somebody tells us to do something and we think we know a better way of doing it, and then when we do it our way, well, it's actually the wrong way and we do it wrong, and it just, we make a mess of it. But you know, the Bible tells us that we shouldn't do things the way we think we should do them, or the way we want to do them. The Bible tells us that we should do things the way God says. You know, the Bible is life's instruction manual. You know, if you ever get furniture and you have to build the thing up, and it never happens in our house because I don't do any of those things. I don't follow instructions. I can't follow instructions, so I just stay clear of all of those things. But there's an instruction manual, and it tells you, you know, step 1, step 2, step 3, and by the time you get to step 122, you have no idea what you're supposed to do. But if you follow the instructions, well, then that's supposed to be how you build that item of furniture. Well, you know, it goes in a far better way for the Bible. We want to live our lives not to please others or not to please ourselves, but ultimately to please God. Then we have to do what God says. We have to trust in the Lord with all our heart. Not just trust Him and believe Him and obey Him with some things that we want to do, but trust Him with all of our hearts. And you know, the most important thing that we could do and must do, if we're ever going to be saved, is to do what the Bible says, not what we think. Not enough just to be a good boy or a good girl, that's good, and to do what our mums and dads tell us, that's very important as well. But we have to be saved the way the Lord says. And the only way we can be saved according to the Bible is to trust in the Lord Jesus Christ with all our hearts, to turn away from our sin and ask Jesus Christ into our hearts. So, whenever we want to do things that will be done right and done properly, mightn't always be the most popular way of doing it. Our friends might want to do another way and do another thing. But whenever we do things the way that God wants us to do them, well then, we'll be doing them right. And that's what the verse is telling us. That's what the verse is teaching us. Do things according to the word of God. So let's do it one more time, and then we'll split it up a wee bit and see how we get on. All right, so give yourselves a big shake. All right, that's it. Really, really shake yourself. Good, good. And we're ready to go after two. One, two. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. Very good. Okay, so what we're going to do this time is ping pong, okay? This is very easy to do, but always I get confused. But we're going to try it anyway. So I will do the word the, you will do the Bible, and the adults out here in the meeting tonight, they will be pretending to be with you out there. So I will say the, you'll say Bible, I'll say says, and so on and so forth, all right? And as they always say, don't follow me because I'll just totally lead you astray. All right, so I'll start off with the, then Bible says in, okay? So after two, one, two, the
Bible
says
in
Proverbs
chapter
3,
verse
5,
trust
in
the
Lord
with
all
thine
heart,
and
lean
not
unto
thine
own
understanding.
Good, very good, very good. Well done. Okay, so we're going to speed it up a wee bit more this time. Did you all get it right? Nobody said the wrong words in the wrong place? No? Okay, well, good. Let's do it again, and we'll speed it up a wee bit more and see how we can do it again. So again, I'll start off with the, and then the Bible, and so on like that. Okay, so after two, one, two. The
Bible
says
in
Proverbs
chapter
3,
verse
5.
Trust
in
the
Lord
with
all
thine
heart,
and
lean
not
unto
thine
own
understanding.
Very good, very good. That's very, very good. So let's turn it around this time. We'll maybe slow it down a wee bit till we get right into the rhythm. And you will start the word the, and then I'll say Bible, you say says, and so on. Okay, so you start it off this time. All right, you're ready? After two, one, two.
The
Bible
says
in
Proverbs
chapter
3,
verse
5,
trust
in
the
Lord
with
all
thine
heart,
and
lean
not
unto
thine
own
understanding. Very good. Well done. Okay, let's see if we can do it this time without some of the words. Okay, the washing machine's going round and round, and let's see how we get on. So let's do it all together this time after three. One, two, three. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. Very good, very good. Let's see, we've got more covered up words this time. Let's see how we get on. Okay, after two this time. One, two. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. Okay, we're going to finish off just one more time. And we're going to do the volume control, okay? So whenever I have my hand up here, we just do it at the normal volume. If I raise my hand up, we raise our voice, we lower my hand, then you lower your voice. So let's see how we get on, okay? So just normal voice to start with. After two, one, two. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, lean not unto thine own understanding. Very good, very good. So, I wonder who's going to learn that verse for next week? Who's going to learn that verse? And who is going to get their mum or their dad to record it and send it in? All right? Because if you do, there'll be a prize. All right? So if you send your verse in, send it in by WhatsApp to the number that's on the screen. Get your mummy or daddy to record you saying that verse. And all the children that send their recordings in to me by Friday will get a prize. All right? Okay? So you need to record it. Get your mummy or daddy to record it. Send them in. And you will get a prize, all right? So, hand back now to Andy Rachel, and we'll have a few more songs. Thank you.
Okay. What a wonderful set of verse. Okay, don't forget to send it in for next week. Can you go this way? Okay. Okay, Isaac, do you want to come and help me? Okay, my God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. Don't forget all the actions for the mountains and the rivers and the stars. Lots of actions for this one. Okay.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are His, the rivers are His, the stars are His handiwork too. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you.
Okay. I thought there was two slides. That one was just the one. What an amazing chorus about how big and strong and mighty God is. And it's great actions. And then we've got wide as the ocean, high as the heavens above. And I'm just going to read out the wee shout outs first of all. We have got Auntie Shirley and Hannah. And then we've got another Hannah and Amy. And we've got the Knowles family all the way over in south of England, in Lewis. And we've got Isaac's Auntie Ruth is watching. Give her a wave. Hello, Auntie Ruth. And we have got Alice Kennedy and Barley. Woof! Hello, Barley. And we've got Lydia and the Twinnigans and Milo down in Carrick. Don't roll off at me. Talking to the dog. It's okay. Okay. So we've got wide as the ocean. Okay. Everybody standing up again. We'll do these actions before we have our story for tonight. Tonight.
So thank you, Rachel. Did anybody else think they were on a Caribbean island there for just a few moments with that, those tin drums and all? If only. But anyway, maybe another time. So tonight we're going to start off a new series of stories. And in our story tonight and over the next number of weeks, we're going to learn about tonight a young man by the name of William. And you know, William was so excited. He just couldn't believe it. His daddy had got a new job. And he and his sisters were going to move to a bigger house. See, the house they had been living in was just a wee small house. And William had to share his room with his sisters because there was no other rooms. And they all lived together in this wee small house. But his daddy had got a new job and they were moving, and they were moving to a bigger house. And in this new house, William was going to have his own room. He couldn't wait. So excited. Now maybe if you were going to have your own room, you would think about maybe the wallpaper you were going to put into it, or maybe the pictures you were going to put on the wall, or what sort of duvet you were going to have. Those sort of things didn't interest William. Do you know what he was so excited about? Was that whenever he would move to his own room in his new house, that he would be able to keep birds. Imagine. See, William loved nature. William loved all about nature. He loved about hearing and reading about birds, learning more about birds. He loved learning about the plants. He loved learning about the trees. He just loved learning about flowers and anything to do with nature. William loved it. And he couldn't wait to move into his new house, into his own room, because he was going to keep his birds in his own room. Imagine being in a room with birds and them moving about and flying about and all the rest of it. But William loved it. In fact, William was so well known at school, and he was only in primary school at this stage, that everybody knew if they had any questions to do with geography or nature, they didn't go to the teacher. They went to William, because William knew everything that there was to know about nature. And he was an explorer. And he was always a very determined wee boy. And there was nothing going to keep him back. And one day he was out walking in the fields around his new home. And he looked up and he saw a bird's nest in the tree. Now he knew it was wrong to go and touch the bird's nest if there were birds or baby birds in it. But he knew that the nest was empty. He knew that all the babies had flown away and the nest wasn't being used anymore, because it would be wrong to touch a nest that there were wee baby birds in. But he knew, because he knew all about nature, that the birds had flown and there was nobody in the nest. And he thought, I'm going to climb up and I'm going to investigate that nest. I'd like to find out, how did the mummy bird put that nest all together? And so he climbed up the tree. And he was grabbing the nest, and oh, guess what happened? He fell down and fell out of the tree. But that didn't put him off. He climbed up again, and this time he got the nest. He was a very determined young boy. But you see, the time came for William to leave school behind. Because whenever William was a wee boy, all boys and girls left school at the age of 12. Imagine being able to leave school at the age of 12. Wouldn't that have been great? But anyway, we have to stay on to school for a wee bit longer today. But whenever William was a wee boy, he had to leave school at the age of 12. And he had to go and work. He just couldn't stay at home and have a holiday the rest of his life. He had to go out and work. And so he talked to his daddy and he thought, what can I go and do? And William says, I know what I want to do. I want to be a gardener. I want to learn more about the plants. I want to learn more about all the vegetables and how all they grow. And so William went off to work as a gardener. But you see, it didn't really work out, because obviously being a gardener, you had to be out in the sun all day, and you had to be outside all day, and the sun affected William. It affected his skin, and he came out in blotches and rashes, and he was really, really sore. And he thought, well, I can't continue like this. I'm going to have to do something else. He didn't want to give up. And so he talked to his daddy again. He says, Daddy, I can't stay out in the sun all day. I love learning about the plants, and I'd love to be able to work with my hands, but I just can't be a gardener. What else do you think I could do? And so they talked for a wee while and talked for another wee while and thought, ah, there's something William could do with his hands. William could be a cobbler. Now you might be thinking, what's a cobbler? That's not a word we hear today very much. But a cobbler is a shoemaker, one who makes shoes, because you see, most shoes now are all made in a factory, all made by some sort of machine, some sort of robot makes machines. But way back in William's time, all the shoes were made by hand, by a shoemaker or a cobbler. And this just suited William right down to the ground, because he was able to investigate how the shoes were put together and all the great detail that went into making the shoes. And he just loved it. And so he went off to work with this man by the name of Mr. Clark Nichols. Mr. Clark Nichols was the cobbler in the local town, and he took on William as an apprentice, and he was going to teach William for the next 7 years how William could make shoes. But you know, through all of this time, while William loved the things that God made, he loved the birds, he loved the plants, he didn't love the God that made all those things. Now, William's daddy was a Christian, William's daddy was saved, but William wasn't saved. But you know, in that cobbler's shop, in that shoemaker's shop, there was a young man who was also learning the trade, also learning how to make shoes along with William, and his name was John Watt. Isn't it wonderful, boys and girls, how the Lord always puts the right people in our lives at the right time? And there in William's life came this young boy, the same age as William, by the name of John Watt. John and William were doing the same trade, they were learning the same thing, but John started to speak to William about being saved. He started to tell him about the Saviour. He started to tell him about Jesus Christ and how we need to ask Jesus Christ into his heart to forgive his sins. But William didn't really give much thought to it. But one day, Mr. Nichols, the boss, he asked William, William, would you go and buy me some things? We need some things for the shop, and here's some money. Would you go and buy me some things for the shop and get them for me and bring them back? And William said, yes, of course. So William had the money in his pocket, and he went off to the shop and he started to buy the things that Mr. Nichols needed for his work. But William thought, well, I could maybe buy a few things for myself here. And he looked in his pocket and he thought, I don't really have very much money. And then he looked at the money that Mr. Nichols had given him, and there was more money. And he thought, well, I could take some of that money and I could replace it with my money. It would be different, but Mr. Nichols would never know it wouldn't. Nothing would be wrong. But you see, boys and girls, it was wrong. Because what William was doing was stealing. And that's what he did. And he thought Mr. Nichols wouldn't realise it. Anyway, he brought all the stuff back to the shop, and he brought the items back to Mr. Nichols and said, there you go, Mr. Nichols. There's the things that you wanted me to buy in the shop. And there's the money left over. And Mr. Nichols started to look at the money and says, there's some missing here, William. Missing? No. You must have got it wrong. William, there's money missing here. You see, there's a wee verse in the Bible that says, be sure your sin will find you out. And William's sin was found out by Mr. Nichols. And William started to think, oh no. Oh no, I've really blown it now. I've lost my job. Mr. Nichols does not want to have anything more to do with me. I've lost it. I've blown it. But you know, Mr. Nichols started to talk to William and he says, you know, William, I'm very disappointed. I'm very annoyed that you took that money that wasn't yours. If you'd wanted money, I would have given it to you. And William said, listen, I'm very, very sorry. I know I shouldn't have done it. And Mr. Nichols said to William, I forgive you. I forgive you. And William started to think back about how John, his friend, had started to tell him about Jesus Christ and how that Jesus Christ could forgive sins. You see, at that time, William started to realize that he was a sinner. Even though he was a young boy, he realized that he was a sinner. And you know, boys and girls, tonight, mums and dads, the Bible tells us that we are all born in sin. That's not a very nice thing to think about. It's not a very pleasant thing to think about. But we're all born in sin. And William started to realize, I am a sinner. And then he started to remember what John had said to him about Jesus Christ. And John would have talked to William about the cross and how that on the cross Jesus died to forgive us our sins. And William started to think, Mr. Nichols has forgiven me my sin. And then he realized, I need to ask Jesus Christ into my heart to forgive me of all my sins. Mr. Nichols just forgave him of that sin that he did in stealing the money. But William realized, I need to ask Jesus into my heart to forgive me all my sins. You know, boys and girls, I wonder, have you ever done that? Have you ever asked Jesus Christ into your heart to forgive you of your sin? Because you know, that's what William then did. He realized he was wrong. He realized he was a sinner. And he went to his bed. On the side of his bed, he kneeled down. He said, Lord, I'm sorry for what I've done. Please forgive me of my sin. And that day, young William got saved. And you know, that was only the beginning of great days in the life of young William. Mr. Nichols, who was his boss, he sadly passed away. And William couldn't work anymore for Mr. Nichols. There was no job for him. And so he moved to another cobbler's shop. And he started working for this other cobbler. But he had learned his trade by this time. And he was now a fully fledged cobbler. But sadly his other employer passed away as well. And this time William thought, well, I'm going to take over the shop. And I'm going to run this shop. And he said, I'm also going to look after this man's wife and his family. I need to provide for them. And then in the midst of all of this, William himself had grown up and he had got married. So he had to provide for his own wife. And he wanted to provide for the wife of his employer who had just died and also their family. And he worked really hard because William was very determined at what he did. And he worked hard making shoes all the hours that he could, but it wasn't enough. And William then started to take on another job because William was very smart, very intelligent. And what he did was he was going to teach adults at night. Because William loved to read. And William had a great understanding. And he started to teach the adults in class at night. And this was to provide more money for him that he could pay for the bills for his wife and for the other family as well. But while William was reading many books and learning more and more things and teaching them in the night class as well, there was one book that he really loved more than anything else, and that was his Bible. William loved his Bible. And you know, William was so intelligent that he started to read the Bible in the original language. He started to read the Old Testament in Hebrew, and he started to read the New Testament in Greek. And he could understand it. He taught himself those languages. And so there he was, working all the hours, night and day, day and night, to provide for his family and to provide for the other family as well. And then one night he was just getting into bed and he started to read this book, another book. And this book, if you can see from the front of it, it's entitled Captain Cook's Voyages. You see, William loved his geography. He loved learning about places, and he was learning about this man, Captain Cook, who went around many different places and discovered many different places that were undiscovered. And in this book, Captain Cook wrote about all the places he went to, and he wrote as well about the people in those places. And William was reading, and he was reading about all the different places across the world that he had never heard of. But he was reading about all the different people, all the different tribes. And something started to work in William's heart. And he started to think, you know, I'm saved. I have heard the gospel. But these people, has anybody ever gone and told them about Jesus Christ? Has anybody ever gone and told them that there's a Savior who can forgive their sins as well? And this started to work in William's heart and mind. And William started to pray. And he started to pray, and he prayed to the Lord, Lord, send people. Send someone to go and tell these people in these foreign lands, these far off lands, go and tell them of Jesus Christ. Lord, send somebody, would you? But you know, we're going to learn how that the Lord answered William's prayer. But he answered it in a way that he never thought or he never imagined. Because that man, that one person that the Lord was going to send to tell some of these people about the Lord Jesus Christ was William himself. Because as we go through all of our lessons over the next number of weeks, we're going to learn more about William. We've learned tonight about him as the young cobbler, the shoemaker. We're going to learn how William went on to be the great missionary, William Carey, who went to tell others of Jesus Christ. And so I want you to tune back in next week as we learn more about this wonderful story, this wonderful life of how the Lord answered William's prayer, but the Lord used William. Even though he wasn't thinking about himself, the Lord was going to send William to tell the others about Jesus Christ. Boys and girls, thank you for listening tonight. But remember what William did all those years before. As a young boy, he realized he was a sinner. And he realized he needed to ask Jesus Christ into your heart, into his heart. I wonder, have you ever done that? If not, then even tonight, why not ask Jesus into your heart to save you? And if you have, you know, boys and girls, you might be thinking to yourself, and you've heard all about the missionaries, we're going to hear more about William Carey and all the present day missionaries as well. Wouldn't it be wonderful if some young person listening to Explorers Club at some stage later in their life was to go to be a missionary and tell others. The greatest thing we can tell is that Jesus died. Jesus rose again. Jesus loves sinners. I wonder even you mightn't be able to go, like we're going to find out about William, but you can go and tell your family. You can go and tell your neighbours. You can go and tell your friends at school that there's a Saviour who loves them. So let's tune in. Make sure we tune in again next Tuesday night. God willing, at 7 o'clock. And we're going to sing more choruses, learn more memory verses, and we're going to learn more about the life of young William Carey. Let's bow in a wee word of prayer just now. Our Father and our God, we thank thee for being with us tonight. We thank thee, Lord, for the life of William Carey. Lord, we thank thee for how you saved him. And Lord, we pray that even as we learn more about him over the next number of weeks, we pray, Lord, you'll speak to all of our hearts. Lord, we pray that for each one that's saved, Lord, help us to go and tell others about what the Lord Jesus Christ has done. Lord, we mightn't have to cross the oceans, but Lord, even help us to cross the street to tell someone about the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless all the explorers who've been watching and with us tonight. We pray, Lord, you'll be with them, keep them safe at school. Watch over them, O God, we pray. Keep them all well. Keep your hand upon all of us, we pray. In the Saviour's name we ask. Amen. Amen. So boys and girls, thank you very much for being with us tonight. Don't forget, get your memory verse, record your memory verse, and tune it in. And that'll be us for tonight. So thank you very much. Oh yes, there's the sweets. Forgot about the sweets. Well, actually, there's different sweets tonight. We've got party rings. Party rings, all right? Who likes party rings? Wee bag of party rings for you. Okay, so this will go with your tea or your coffee before you get to bed. Okay, so ready? After three, one, two, three. Oh, very good. Well done. And here's a drumstick, all right, just to really rot your teeth and pull out all your dentures. After three, one, two, three. There we go. Well done. Okay, boys and girls, thank you so much for being with us tonight. Really appreciate you tuning in. Make sure you come back again next Tuesday night. Get your memory verses in, and you'll get a prize if you send your memory verse in before Friday, and we'll get it shown up next week as well. Good night, and God bless you.